Good evening, everybody. How you doing? I've just returned from Medicine Festival today. Just got back, just crawled into bed. Oh, I had a really good time. I really enjoyed it. I think it was the best festival weekend I've ever been on. It was just great in every way. The festival itself was great in terms of the, you know, the organization, and the site itself was lovely. It was on some private land called the Wasin Estate in Berkshire. And there's a lake and a forest, and it was just really lovely in that kind of setting. But also the music, the food, the people, the workshops, everything about it was great. And it's a sober environment, so there's no alcohol. So everyone there is peaceful and calm and pleasant. You know, there's no aggro, there's no aggression, there's nothing rowdy, there's none of that. There's no bad energy. It's all lovely vibes. And to be honest, I find it difficult to imagine going to a normal festival after being in those kind of environments, because you get so used to it. It's so pleasant and so enjoyable. It's so easy to talk to people. The thought of going to a normal gig or a normal festival where, you know, where there's a bunch of drunk dickheads, it just doesn't appeal. It just doesn't appeal at all. It's kind of, yeah, it sort of feels a bit repulsive. And the thing is with sort of healing type of events, conscious type of events, as Medicine Festival is, it creates a feeling, an atmosphere of comfort and safety. So people feel safe to interact more and open up more and share more. So there's more, you know, there's more intimacy between people because people share more of themselves because it's safe to do so. And that's the whole point of healing environments. You know, the whole point is to sort of dive deep into yourself and sort of look for the areas where you're stuck. And that's the whole point of it. That's what it's all about. That's what the workshops are for. That's what the healing's for. That's the whole ethos and culture of that world is all about being honest, being open, being authentic, and creating safe environments where people feel comfortable to do so. That is what it is. So it's very much the opposite of the normal world, really, you know, because getting drunk or taking drugs or getting high and that kind of thing is very much about sort of running away from your stuff and avoiding it and distracting yourself from it and numbing it out so that you don't have to deal with it. You know, that's what the normal world does. But with conscious events, it's the opposite. You know, you go inward and it's great. Yeah, it's really, really good. So I find it so easy to make friends in that kind of environment because everyone's on the same page, really. Everyone's got very similar values. Everyone's there because they like the same kind of music. Everyone's there for the workshops. Everyone's there to meet like-minded people. So it's so easy to make friends. I've made loads of friends at those type of environments. There was people there that I've known for years. There was people there that have come to my Real Awake events. There was people there that I met last year and made friends with. And then there's new friends this year. So it's great. It's great for interaction. Yeah, I really enjoy that. And definitely I can remember, times earlier in my life where my social life was very bleak and I couldn't figure out how to find the right kind of people. And I couldn't figure out how to find the right type of environments to be in. And it's, you know, so I always appreciate the contrast between where I was and where I am now. You know, I feel very rich in friends and connections and stuff. So, yeah, I never take that for granted. So, but everyone's on their journey. You know, some people, I don't know. What am I saying? I'm not sure what I'm saying. Yeah, everyone gets there eventually. I think that's what I'm trying to say. Just a great weekend. I had a lot of fun. The musicians, the medicine musicians from all over the world. There's variety, you know. There's DJs and dance. There's acoustic music. There's bands, but it's all medicine music. It's not ego music. It's all heart open music. It's hard to describe it, but it feels very pure and divine and uplifting and deep and real. That's the best way I can describe it, really. I think normal culture and normal music is just entangled with weird energy and, you know, anger and sexual energy and discontent and jealousy and confusion. It's all in the lyrics, and ooh, it's yucky. I was chatting to my friend Erica about it. We were saying, like, it's so hard to listen to normal music after you've been listening to Medicine Music, because it's just icky, you know. It's just infected with horrible shadow ego, scarcity, fear, you know, all just yucky energy. I can't explain it, but you can, it's viscerally sort of repulsive kind of thing. But Medicine Music is just as pure as it gets, you know. It's just straight from the heart, straight from the soul. Yeah, it's great. So that's the best way I can put it into words, really. So yeah, it was bigger this year. Apparently there were 7,000 people this year. There was 4,000 last year. And it was noticeably bigger. There was more people, you know, could feel it. And there was more spaces, there was more stages, more things going on. But the quality of everything that was happening, you know, wherever you go, if you walk over to a fire, there'd be 100 people sat around and a musician playing and people singing. If you go to the dance tent, there'd be 300 people in there dancing. If you go to a workshop space, there'd be 60 people sat in there doing a workshop. If you go to the forest, there'd be 200 people stood around listening to someone perform. Like, there was something going on everywhere all the time, and it was all top quality. So, yeah, really lovely. I personally enjoy doing a couple of workshops in the day and then relaxing in the afternoon and sort of just wandering around and listening to music and catching up with friends. So the conscious connection workshops is generally what I enjoy. So what generally happens is there'll be a facilitator who'll be leading the process, and it just gives some structure. So it's a bit like networking in a way. You know, they might set you games to do where you have to get into pairs and ask each other questions. And it just gives you some structure to sort of push you out of your comfort zone a little bit and just encourage people to open up and connect more than they normally would do, you know, of their own accord. So it's just a nice way of connecting with others in a comfortable kind of way. And the facilitators are great, you know, they know what they're doing, they're well practiced at it, they know how to make people feel safe, they know how to lead a session. It's great, you know, it's a great way of meeting people. I went to psychedelic speed friending, which is a quirky title, but it's sort of, well, you basically sort of spend 10 minutes with one person and you're given questions to ask each other that sort of causes you to sort of dig deep and sort of share things about yourself, and then you move on to the next person, and that was quite fun. And I did play fighting, which was really good actually. There was about 60 or 70 people there, and it started off just with some sort of icebreaker games just to loosen up. Like, people, it was getting us to do thumb wars and getting us to, you know, just things just to loosen everybody up and make people feel more relaxed. And then, but the main bulk of the workshop was actually wrestling. The aim was to actually pin the other person on the ground with their shoulders on the ground, and it was all demonstrated and explained and all done very, very, you know, in such a way that made everyone feel safe and comfortable. And it was good fun actually. So he then put us into groups and we had to take it in turns to wrestle with each other, but it was great. It was really good. It was nice to do it in a sort of mindful, healthy kind of way, but it was good to have some challenge and some competition and some confrontation, because spiritual environments can be very soft and very feminine, you know, because it's all music and feelings and conversations, and that, you know, there's nothing particularly challenging that you can win or lose at, you know. There's nothing that really you know, there's nothing to engage with in that kind of way. So it was nice to actually bring some of that competitive energy in, which is more masculine. But it's important, you know, it's important to have that holistic range of things, because if you're just doing soft, wafty stuff all the time, you just end up soft, don't you? It's all valuable, but it's important to have all those different energies in the mix. The sauna was great. The lake was great. Oh, I just had a great time, really. But I think making friends is what I enjoy most, really. Made a lot of friends. Yeah, so I feel very at home in those kind of environments. And a lot of the culture of it is very influenced by South American traditional type of culture, because it's very influenced by ayahuasca medicine, really. That's one of the main themes, one of the main aesthetic themes of it all. And it, of course, it's blended with different cultures, different influences, different parts of the world. You know, we've sort of fused it with our own culture a little bit, but it's very informed by South American ayahuasca influence. Yeah, I think there's a lot of people there that are from South America, or originally from South American countries and living in England. So yeah, a lot of very open-hearted people, a lot of deep, compassionate people, just great, really. You know, I can't praise it highly enough. Feel very connected. Most people probably ate magic mushrooms during the course of the weekend. That's quite typical, that's quite normal. I ate a lot of magic mushrooms, but everybody I spoke to, I would quite often ask them if they'd had any mushrooms, and you know, pretty much everyone had. So that's sort of part of it. But psychedelics are very different to drugs, normal drugs, normal recreational drugs. It's a different thing. It sort of causes you to, it's mind expanding. It makes you feel more aware of others and more connected and more integrated, and it just, you know, it's very healing. It causes you to have insight into yourself and realizations, and I'm not just making that up. That is consistently and universally people's experience. You know, it gives people a lot of healing. Firsthand, I can tell you that. You know, I got huge results sort of in my well-being. That's a bit vague, isn't it? But it did a lot for me in terms of making me feel better and bringing me sort of closure on certain things. So I can tell you firsthand, it's very powerful in terms of helping you with whatever you're dealing with. No question about it. I'm not making that up. That's consistently what people's experience is. So yeah, mushrooms are the way. And whenever I've had mushrooms, I always feel very aware of other people, what other people are feeling. I'm very aware of people's body language, and I can sort of feel how open or closed they are, or how anxious or relaxed they are, or how self-centered, or how sort of aware of others they are. You can sort of feel people more. So it makes interactions a lot richer and a lot more nuanced, I suppose. So it is great for interacting with. But yeah, visually the sight was great. You know, they had coloured lights lighting up the trees. They had fairy lights everywhere. It was very beautiful, very artistic. It was great attention to detail in that kind of way. And yeah, everyone had a blast. Really, really good. So I'll definitely be going next year. And of course, I've got my own events, Real Awake, which is just a smaller version of the same thing. Same type of atmosphere, same type of values, same type of ethos, same type of focus, but just with 25 people rather than 7,000. So check that out. And all right, everyone, that's me done. So I just thought I'd tell you about it. Oh, I smoked Changa as well, which is DMT. I was chatting to some people and made friends with them, and one of the people in the group had Changa. They put it in a vaporizer so you could inhale it. it wasn't for sale. You don't buy DMT. It's given, it's shared, in my experience. Funny enough, I've heard Mike Tyson say that as well. And like, you never sell DMT. It's always shared. Because if you try and profit from it, it'll bite you on the ass. So it's interesting, isn't it? That was quite strong. That was sort of like magic mushrooms, but sort of 10 times quicker and 10 times stronger. So it sort of takes you to a very sort of blissed out kind of state. I'm not very sensitive to psychedelics. When I did ayahuasca, it had a very gentle effect on me. When I do mushrooms, they have a very gentle effect on me. When I did Changa, it has a very gentle effect on me. But other people completely leave their body. You know, they come back feeling transformed, like they've downloaded thousands of years of knowledge in a few minutes, kind of thing. They really do feel that way. You know, it really does transform people. It creates very big sort of instant shifts and realizations in people. They feel like they've met God. They feel like, you know, it's strong, it's powerful. But it was quite gentle for me, but still a good experience. So I'm quite comfortable doing things like that. So that was a nice experience. But yeah, I just really enjoyed catching up with my friends, really, and making new friends. That was the best bit for me. Anyway, so there we go. That's my review of the festival. So check it out. And I'll catch you guys soon. Bye for now.